Hello, my name is Ardi and we are going to solve problem 4.45 from Sohm's outline of electric circuit. And the question is, in the circuit 4.51, write 3 node equation for nodes A, B, and C with node D as the reference. So this means this node here is our ground, right? So let me draw a ground here. And let's just write that our voltage in this node here is 0, and we are asked to find all the node voltages. Okay, and we are going to use node voltage method, or some other books call it nodal analysis. So we need to do KCL at each node. So here we have some currents given. Maybe we should use this as our guide, maybe. So the current will be going there, and for this one, because there is two currents, I1 and I2, but I will choose maybe we are going to the right, and for this one maybe I want to go to the right, and for this one maybe I will going. Why? Because this is 3 volt, and remember that this 3 volt means that this node is 3 volt from the ground. So let's just write that. So this is 3 volt. Okay, now we have all set, and let's do the first step. We need to do KCL at node A first. Okay. And KCL said that the sum of the currents that goes in is equal to the sum of the currents that goes out, and there is only one current that goes in, which is this from 3 ampere. Okay, let me write that. So I will have 3 on the left hand side as the only current that goes in, and then there are 2 currents that goes out. The first one is this one, and this is going from VA to VB, so I will have VA minus VB, and it will need to be divided by the resistance between them, so divided by 2. And this current is going out from node A also, so similarly we can just use that formula. So VA minus VC, because the current is going from A to C, so VA minus VC, and then divided by the resistance value between them, which is 7. Okay, now maybe we should do simplifying this equation, and I want to multiply both sides by 14, right? And multiplying by 14, I will have for the left hand side 42, and then for this one, this will cancel into 7, so we'll have 7 VA minus VB, and then for this fraction here, this 7 will cancel into 2 with 14, so we'll have 2 VA minus VC. Okay, now let's distribute the 7 and the 2 to the parentheses, so I will have 42 is equal to 7 VA minus 7 VB plus 2 VA and then minus 2 VC, right? And now we have 7 VA plus 2 VA here, so I will have 42 is equal to 9 VA and minus 7 VB minus 2 VC. Okay, I think there is no other ways to continue from here, so maybe let's save this as equation number 1. Okay, and let's do KCL at other node, which is node B. So I want to do KCL at node B. Okay, again we have the sum of the current that goes in is equal to the sum of the current that goes out. Okay, now the only current that goes in is from here, which is going from 3 volt node to B node, which is VB, right? And we need to divide it by the resistance between them, which is 2. So this is one of the current that goes in, and then this current is also goes in, so we'll have plus, we already calculate this before, which is VA minus VB divided by 2, and there is no other currents that goes in, so we move on to the current that goes out here, which is from here to here, or from VB to VC, so I'll have VB minus VC, and we divide by the resistance between them, which is 3, and let's multiply both sides by 3. By 3? I think that's not enough. Maybe by 6. Okay, by 6. Okay, now if we multiply this by 6, I will have 3 multiplied by 3 minus VB, and then plus 3 VA minus VB, and then that will equal to 2 VB minus VC, right? And let's distribute this, all of this, so I'll have 9 minus 3 VB, and then plus 3 VA minus 3 VB, and this will equal to 2 VB minus 2 VC. Okay, and now I will have, what is it? So I want to move all of this into right hand side, so I will have 9. And for VA, I only have one term here, so I will have minus 3 VA. And for VB, I will have minus 3 minus 3, which is minus 6. And I move to the right hand side, so I will have 2 plus 6, which is 8. I will have 8 VB. And for VC, I think we only have one here, minus 2 VC. So this is the second equation, and finally we need to do one more KCL, which is at node C. Okay, let's do it here. So let's use red. Okay, I will have KCL at node C, and we need to do the sum of the currents that goes in is equal to the sum of the currents that goes out, and I need to assume one more current, I think. Maybe it's here. So from here there are two currents that goes in, which is this one and this one, and we already calculated that before, so let's rewrite that. So from here to here, that will be VA minus VC divided by 7, and from here to here, that will be VB minus VC divided by 3, and that will equal to this current that goes out here, which is VC minus 0, or we just write VC divided by 1. Okay, now what can we do here is multiply this by 21, right? And so I will have, what is it, 3, or maybe I should put some line here so we don't get confused later. Okay, so I will have this 3 VA minus 3 VC, right? Because this 7 and 21 will cancel into 3, and we multiply by this term, and then plus 7 VB minus 7 VC, and that will equal to, okay, I need some space, maybe move a little bit to the left, that's okay, and that will equal to 21 VC, right? We'll have 21 VC. Now moving all of this to the left hand side, so I will have 3 VA, and then I will have plus 7 VB, and lastly I will have minus 30 VC, yeah, and minus 7 minus 21, I mean this one is minus 3 VC minus 7 VC minus 10, and then minus 10 we minus again with minus 21, so I will have minus 31, yeah, sorry about that, got messed up, minus 31 VC, so I will have 0. Okay, I think there is not much that we can do here, so I will have this as equation number 3. Okay, I have this as first equation, and then this one as second equation, and this one as our third equation. Okay, and the final thing that we need to do is just to calculate them by using maybe some elimination or substitution. Let's do that. Okay, now from the circuit we have three equations with three variables, and we should be able to solve this. Okay, there are several ways, but I want to use the most traditional way, which is elimination and substitution. Okay, now if we take a look here, we have 9 VA minus 3 VA and 3 VA, so maybe I want to use equation number 1 plus 3 times equation number 2, right? So let's rewrite the first equation. Okay, let me copy paste that. Yeah, I'm too lazy to write it again. And then, okay, now we multiply this equation 2 by 3, right? So I will have minus 9 VA and then plus 24 VB, then minus 6 VC, and that will equal to 27. Okay, now what can we do here is we add both of them, right? So I will have on the right hand side 42 plus 27 will be 69, right? And then here I will have minus 7 plus 24, which is 17 VB, and minus 2 minus 6 will be minus 8 VC. Okay, let's save that maybe as equation number 4. Now we have an equation with two variables, so we need one more. Maybe I will do equation number 2 plus equation number 3, because this minus 3 and 3 will cancel each other, right? So I'll have equation number 2 and 3. So I will have, okay, let's just add them together. Maybe let's copy these two. Okay, excuse me. Yeah, and then okay, let's just add them up. Plus, so I will have 15 VB minus What is it? 33 BC will equal to 9. Okay. Now I will have equation number 4 and number 5. What can we do from here? I don't think they are a good number. So let's just rewrite them. 17 VB minus 8 VC is equal to 69. And then 15 VB minus 33 VC is equal to 9. And so I can do the first one will be multiplied by 15 and the second one will be multiplied by 17. Okay. Now maybe I should get my calculator. Okay, that's messy. Okay, I need to do 15 multiplied by 17, right? 255. Okay. 255. A significant number if you do a binary or digital system. And then minus 8 multiplied by 15. Okay, 8 multiplied by 15 is 120. 120 VC. And then minus 33 multiplied by 17 is 561. 561 VC. And this will equal to, okay, the number is not friendly. 69 multiplied by 15 will be 1035. And then for the second one, I will have 17 multiplied by 9, which is 153. And from here I can subtract, so we will have this VB cancelled, and then so I will have this one. Okay, maybe let's just use calculator again. Divided minus 120, so I'll have 441. 441 VC, and then this one will be 882. And from here I will get VC is equal to 2. Okay, let's highlight that because this is one of the answer that we are looking for. And then what can we do here? We can just plug this into one of this. Maybe I will just plug it into equation number 5. So I will have 15 VB minus 33 VC, but VC is 2, right? So I'll have 2, and that will equal to 9. And let's do some little math here. This is minus 66 and 9, or 15 VB is equal to 75, right? And so I will have VB is equal to 5. And let's also highlight this because this is also one of the answer that we are looking for. And then finally we can just plug VB and VC into one of this equation. Okay, maybe I want to do the first one. We'll have 9 VA minus 7 VB, but 7 VB is 7 multiplied by 5, so I'll have 35. And then minus 2 multiplied by 2, or 4, right? Yeah, 4. And that will equal to 42. or 9VA is equal to 42 plus 39, yeah, or 9VA is equal to 81, and VA is equal to 94. And so we got all the node voltage, which is the one that we are looking at the problem. Yeah, and we got the our answer is the same as the answer key. So I think I did not make any mistake in my calculation. And okay, I think that's enough. Leave a comment if you want to ask question, and bye bye.